Hi guys, welcome back. My name's Shada Campbell. So I've been an artist for a long time, but I've only been a working artist for the last 2 years, and that's directly because of social media. I built a blog and then a YouTube channel and then an Instagram presence. And now I get jobs doing cool stuff like, lately I designed the packaging for one of my favorite art brands, more on that later. But even better than that, I hear from you guys and you tell me that you've developed your own knitting business or felting or watercolor painting, and it's all because of the online world and specifically social media. Now today's video is sponsored by PicMonkey, so we're gonna do a continuation of a subject that we covered a few videos back. A few weeks ago we were talking how to get noticed, how to get your work noticed on social media. We talked lighting, editing, styling, and today we're gonna get into the specifics of creating impactful Instagram stories. Yes, you wanna post a story probably every day, but you want them to be really cool, but you also don't want them to take a long time. And that's what we're gonna tackle today. So let's get started. So the name of the game is high impact, beautiful stories that don't take you a long time, because hypothetically you're putting out lots of these. So we're on the PicMonkey homepage, we go to create, I'm gonna grab a photo off my computer. It's just something, a little snap I took late one evening after work. And we'll quickly go over the PicMonkey edit menu. So your menu's along the left. The top one here is your basic edits, all the most important stuff like crop and straighten, exposure, colors. Next, you have some more interesting effects. Maybe you wanna make it look old or sepia. All of that stuff is here. And then after that, you're in the touch-up menu. So if you have a person in the photo you want to teeth whiten, you can do that. You can add text in the text menu. The objects and overlays is all kinds of fun little cute things that you might want to add, especially to a story. And today we're going to work with a few of these. So I'm going to start by sizing the photo in the main edits menu here. And stories are 16:9 crop in the vertical, of course. And so I can just choose that from the menu, and then I can crop my photo so that I know I'm working with the proper sized photo. That's the very first thing I want to do, and just quickly frame it nicely and click apply. And then we're going to go down to rotate, and that's the straighten. That's where you can straighten. It's very important if you have something like a horizon in there that it's straight. That just helps your photos look really polished. So that's what I'm doing there. And then of course you can use the exposure and, you know, up the brightness a little. I find on a phone where a screen is backlit, you want quite a bright photo. So you might play around a little with contrast and brightness and just get it looking just the way you want, but don't take too much time. You're just putting a little polish on here. And of course you might change the temperature slider so you get that warm photo or a cool photo as to your style and your preference. So now that we've used those basic edits to put a little polish on the photo, we're gonna use some more of these fun ones. I'm going to the overlays. I've grabbed a rectangle that is made up of a frame and a middle, so I've got a transparent midsection on this one, and you can see it creates sort of a nice frame. I'm gonna stretch it out here to give it sort of a framing in effect, you'll see, but the PicMonkey interface has a nice grid there, so you know when it's centered. You can stretch it out, and then I'm gonna change the color, and I'm just gonna pick up a nice light pink, sort of one of the colors in the sunset. And you can see that just adds a little something to this photo. It didn't take me long, it's not super complicated, but it just gives it a little something extra, and it's definitely something that you can't do on the Instagram app. And I think that's the key here, is that we're adding things that people are gonna say, ooh, that's neat, how'd she do that? And you don't wanna spend a lot of time on it, you just wanna give your photos that edge. I'm adding a font, of course, as well, that is not on the Instagram app. So I've chosen a fun handwriting font, and I'm just writing my view tonight. I'm gonna change the color of that font or that script to the same pink. And there, I've got something that you know, didn't take very long to do, but that you otherwise wouldn't be able to do on Instagram. And here's the best part. I made this on my laptop, so it was quick and simple. But now when I go over to my phone, I open the PicMonkey app, there's all my photos. I go to the hub, the PicMonkey hub, and my photo is saved there automatically. So I can open it on my phone and post to Instagram instantly and really easily. So the PicMonkey hub is a great tool for moving things between mobile and laptop. And here I'm back on my computer and I'm starting with a canvas size 16 by 9. I've used that same light peachy pink color as the backdrop for the canvas. And then I'm importing my photo that I used previously. I just go to the overlays panel, click add your own, grab a photo off the desktop, and then I just sort of am able to use the PicMonkey grid to center it there. I use the text menu to add a font that isn't on Instagram. I like that Egyptian light. That's a nice sort of typewritery font. And I also like to space out my letters. I'll actually put a full space in between each one. And that just is another nice design element that is simple yet effective. Now that I've finished that on the computer, I come over to my phone, click the PicMonkey icon, open my photo. It's in the hub waiting for me. I like to do some edits on the phone now that I can see it on the actual mobile screen. Maybe I up the contrast and brightness a little bit or the clarity. I love using the draw tool. This is really fun. You can add any color by just moving that plus button around. So I'm gonna pick up that pink that I used, and here I use a stylus to draw onto the photo and just give it these wonky, whimsical edges. So this is just one, again, something really simple and quick, not spending all day on these stories, but it adds this thing where people are gonna say, whoa, how'd she do that? So that's just a fun idea. I think the thing that I like about PicMonkey most is that because the learning curve is so simple, you've got all your fonts, all your shapes, all the doodles right there at your disposal. It means that you can really get creative and imaginative right away because you're not faced with this steep design and photo editing tool learning curve. And right now there's an all new PicMonkey that's in the works, but you guys can try it before everyone else. And if you subscribe using my link in the video description, PicMonkey will add a bonus 3 months to your subscription. My link gets you access to the beta, so register with that. Then to take advantage of the offer, go to picmonkey.com from your desktop to subscribe. And leave me a comment below and let me know, how are you using PicMonkey? And while we're talking PicMonkey, one other thing I wanted to mention is that there's all sorts of different apps. There's apps for collaging photos for stories. There's apps for adding text. But by doing it in one place on my computer, it means I don't have to download 5 different apps for all different things. Maybe I want to add a graphic and text, or maybe I want to do a collage, and I don't have to switch between apps no matter what I come up with, what fun idea I come up with. I can do it all right here. And I don't know, for me, I do find it faster to do it on my laptop and then just grab the photo out of the hub. The finished project is in the hub, and from there I can do the simple edits on my phone. But all the typing, all the design, the collage, that I can use my laptop for. And for me, that's a much faster workflow, especially when I want to have high impact, beautiful stories every day, really. And don't forget about collage. Collage is a great tool for sharing your world. Here I've taken 2 photos from around Charlottetown, my home city, which on their own might not be anything special, but when you put them together, it's showing a vision of what Charlottetown looks like. And I'm sure you guys get this, but once it's on in the hub on your phone, then it's easy to just click share or export. You put it in Instagram. Once it's in Instagram, you can still add all those cute emojis or whatever else you might like to add in the Instagram app. And that's it. This is seriously simple workflow, and it's perfect for the blogger or influencer or artist who wants to have their work online every day and make an impact. Thanks for watching today. I hope you enjoyed the tutorial, and I will see you on Friday with a brand new video. Thanks for watching, and don't forget to subscribe.